Here I'll be covering the management for a Firebox Cloud instance within WatchGuard Cloud. I've already created and configured my AWS instance, so we'll begin by adding our device. And we'll do so by clicking Add Device and then completing the wizard. Because the Firebox Cloud is a software firewall, it doesn't have a TPM chip or a serial number for WatchGuard Cloud to use in order to validate the Firebox is legitimate. So for this, we use a download package, which contains everything necessary to tell the Firebox Cloud who it is and what it's licensed for. Next up, we'll log into our Firebox Cloud and complete the web setup wizard. Here, we'll upload the payload given to us by the Add Device wizard in Cloud. And that's it for the setup. At this point, our Firebox Cloud is now connected for Firebox Cloud management, and we can continue configuring everything from WatchGuard Cloud as we would any other Firebox. For example, creating a policy for north to south traffic, which I'll show you here. I choose the traffic types from and to, and then I select any security services that I want to apply. The final step is to simply deploy the configuration. Cloud-based firewalls also have the flexibility to inspect traffic between different subnets behind the firewall where traffic is passing east to west between these environments. Use cases we see for this architecture include workloads deployed in different environments such as development, testing, and production that require shared services like the example shown here. Hub and spoke network topology is also common in Microsoft Azure. Let's look at an example of how this is set up. For this scenario, we set up another subnet in AWS as shown here. Then we create a policy to control the traffic between them. You'll see that I'm using custom aliases in this example. This allows me to add, remove, change IP addresses associated with the workflow without needing to modify the policy itself each time. Now, something else a little different than the last example is that I chose a custom rule where I can choose to define bidirectional or single directional traffic. That way, I don't need to create a second rule where everything's the same except for the from and to fields have to be swapped. That's it for the public cloud firewall demo. Thank you.